Today we are going to learn lesson number 41, animal adjectives. So what is meant by animal adjectives? Animal adjective means it related to adjectives of animals. So an adjective is a word that describes something by giving some information like size, shape, origin or material. So animal adjective deals with or gives information about the sum of things like size, shape, origin or material of different animals. Okay, so let us move on to the lesson. Please take out your textbook, take lesson number 41 on page number 59. Now first one is canine, and it relates to dogs, and the dog is a domesticated carnivore of the family Canidae, and it is the part of the wolf-like canids and is the most widely abundant terrestrial carnivore. So first adjective is canine, animal adjective is canine, and it deals with dogs. Next one is bovine, and it deals with cows, and it is the adjective of cows. The biological subfamily Bovinae includes a diverse group of 10 genera of medium to large sized unguligates, including domestic cattle, bison, African buffalo, the water buffalo, and the four-horned and spiral-horned antelopes. Here it is, this bovine is an adjective related with cows, and it is a biological subfamily. It is included in the biological subfamily Bovinae, and it includes diverse group of 10 genera, means 10 species of medium to large sized ungulates. Ungulates means large mammals with hooves, and it includes domestic buffalo, domestic cattle, African buffalo, and different types of four-horned and spiral-horned antelopes. Moving on to the next one. Next one is corvine, and it deals with crows. And crow is a bird of genus corvine, or more broadly a synonym for all corvus. And the term crow is used as part of the common name of many species. And in this corvine, different types of bird which looks like crows are being included in the family corvine. Next word is murine, which is the adjective for rats. And the old word rats and mice, part of the subfamily Murinae, in the family Murinae comprises at least 519 species, and members of this subfamily are called murines, and murine is related with rats. Okay, now let us move on to the next one, which is anguine, and that relates to snake-like things or snakes. The adjective anguine is useful for talking about anything that looks like a snake. And although it's most commonly found describing a particular kind of lizard, the anguine or anchored lizard, which is long and scaly and very snake-like. Anguine comes from a Latin root word anguis or snake. So this anguine is an adjective which is related to snakes because it resembles to snake-like objects. Next one is squirrine, which is related to squirrels, and squirrels are members of the family Squirrinae, a family that includes small or medium-sized rodents. The squirrel family includes tree squirrels, ground squirrels, chipmunks, marmots, flying squirrels, and prairie dogs, amongst other rodents. So this is the adjective for squirrels. Moving on to the next one, which is piscine, which is the adjective for fish. Okay, now next one is equine. It is related with horses, and the horse is one of two extant subspecies of Equisferus, and it is an odd-toed ungulate mammal belonging to the taxonomic family equine. So the horse is related to equine. That is, equine is the word or adjective for horses. So we have studied about different types of animal adjectives. Okay, so we have completed this lesson. Please complete this in your textbook. So let us wind up the session for today. Thank you.